Please click on subscribe button and click on bell icon for more interesting updates on civil engineering concepts.
In this video lecture, I will explain you complete detailing of 5-story building model by using ETAP software. So I was already done the modeling process. I was already applied the load cases for this building model. Now I will explain you how to design this particular building structural model by using ETAP's detailing version software. So initially I will explain you how to export the model from ETAP software to ETAP's detailing version software. Then after that, I will explain you how to design this particular structure by using IS 456-2000 CODEL provision standard system. So if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, please click on subscribe button and click on bell icon and keep your notification on for more upcoming videos. So let's start our video. So this is our building model, which is consisting of the grade of the concrete is M30 grade concrete provision and HYSD bar of 500. In the same process, it will be consisting of the beam size is approximately 0.3 into 0.3 and column size is approximately equal to 0.46 into 0.23. In the same process, I was applied the load cases, which is related to gravitation loading condition systems as well as the lateral loading condition system, which is related to dead loading condition, live loading condition, seismic loading condition and wind loading condition system. In the seismic loading condition, I was taken seismic zone, which is related to zone 5 seismic condition. In the same process, I was taken the wind loading condition system, which is related to terrain category of 4 as per IS 875 part 3. So I was applied the load cases related to the self weight of the structure and wall loading condition systems and slab loading condition system and live loading condition system for the building structural model. So after applying the load cases, we need to add the load combinations. Go to select the load combinations option, add a default design combination, which is related to columns as well as, frames as well as the slab. Click on OK so that it will add the load combinations here. Now we have to add the fixed support conditions at the base. So for that, we have to select the base for this particular structural model. Just I'm selecting the base here. Go to assign option, joint, restraint, select as fixed supports, click on apply option, click on OK option so that it will apply the fixed support condition system. Now we have to analyze the structure. For that, go to analyze option, click on check models initially. We have to check this model whether it is correct or not. Just I am checking here my models. So here my model is obtained with zero errors, no warning message. Go to analyze option, click on the run analysis option directly so that it will ask you to save the model. Just I am saving my model to detailing here. Click on save option so that it will do the analysis process for the building structural model. Then after that, I will explain you how to design this particular structure. Now we can see this is the deflection diagram after the analysis process. So now we have to design this building structural model. So before designing the building structural model, we need to add the strip condition system for the slab from first slab to last slab. So initially we need to unlock the model, click on OK. Go to click on edit option here on the top, click on add edit grid strip condition, click on add strip condition. So here we have to select the story number 5, which is of X direction, A direction, click on apply so that it will apply the strip condition system for the A direction. In the same process, we have to apply the strip condition system for the Y direction condition with B, click on apply so that it will apply the strip condition system in the Y direction. In the same process, we have to apply the strip condition system in the fourth also, and in the same process we have to apply the strip condition system for the remaining section. So now we can see here I was applied the all the strip condition system for the slab. Click on OK option. So after this, we have to click on the run analysis option again so that it will do the analysis process again with the considerations of the strips. Now we can see it was done with analysis process again with the considerations of the strip. Now we have to design the beam, column as well as the slab. So initially we will start with the slab section. Go to select the slab design option, select the view revised preferences. So we have to check this whether it is comes under IS code or not. Click on OK. The rest of the parameters we have to keep it constant. Select this option, select your respected start designing check option. So initially it will ask you to select the floors. So here I'm selecting floor number 5 to 1. Why? Because it will be consisting of the slabs from floor number 5 to 1 only. Click on OK so that it will design the slab section according to IS 456-2000 code standard system. Now here you can see it was done with all the slab section according to IS 456-2000 code. So now we have to design the beam section. Go to select the frame section. Select here as view revised preferences option. Select IS 456-2000. Click on OK. Again in the same process we have to select this option. Click on directly design check option. So that it will design the frame sections for the beams as well as the columns according to IS 456-2000 code standard system. So here you can see all the pink color mark are obtained here. So all the beams are passing as per the design consideration. So now we have to save this model by using Ctrl S option so that the model will be saved here. So cancel this ETAP software. Now our task, next task is to do the detailing in detailing version software. So for that just I'm selecting here my detailing version software, 18 version software. So select the file option here. Click on new detailing option. Select open EDB file. Just I'm selecting desktop which is related to detailing. So here I'm selecting D option. So initially the model will be open in ETAP software. Then after that it will be directly imported to detailing version software. So now we can see the model is opening in ETAP software. Then after that it will be imported to detailing version software. Now it was done with complete importing process. So click on OK option here. So firstly we have to select this detailing units option. So we have to select the units as per your consideration. So you can select SI system or else you can select any user interface. So here I'm selecting SI system. Metric length will be in millimeter and the section thickness will be millimeter, bar section will be millimeter, force will be in kilonewton. Just I'm selecting. So rebar length will be, I'm assuming here as meter, square meter is the slab area, concrete volume is cubic meter, and kilogram is the weight of the bar. Click on OK. So again in the same process we have to select the preferences according to Indian standard codal provision standard system. So you can select another option related to detailing preferences option. You can modify according to your consideration. Select this detailing preferences option also. You can modify rebar section rules. Now we have to select the rebar section rules. So here in this case initially we have to enter the minimum spacing and maximum spacing. So here minimum spacing I am assuming here as 120, maximum just I am assuming here as 300, smallest rebar length just I am assuming here as, let us consider 300, otherwise you can enter your, depends upon your consideration. So preferred bar size just you can assume as per your convenient. Just I am taking 16mm bar size. Column strip bottom section just I am assuming 16, medial strip also 16mm, and medial strip condition bottom also just you can consider 12 or 16. So but according to our slab thickness just I am taking 12mm only. So click on the beam option. So we have to enter the minimum spacing option. Just I am taking similar that of 120mm. Again this is also 120mm. So here I am taking 450mm and 450mm, and again I am selecting 450mm. Select the column section. Just I am taking here as 120mm and just I am selecting here as 450mm here. Select here. Click on OK option. Now we have to select the OK option here directly so that it will design the beam section, column section as well as the slab section according to our consideration. So now we can see here it was done with all the detailing process. So this is the slab detailing option. This is the beam detailing option. Select the slab detailing option. So it will be consisting of the bill of materials, rebar quantities option here, which is consisting of the item, volume and unit. Rebar quantity you can select here, and it will be consisting of 10mm diameter bar, 12mm diameter bar for the slab section. In the same process you can select the floor framing plan for the 5th section, and this is a rebar plan for the 6th section for the particular consideration. In the same process you can consider this rebar floor plan for the top rebar plan, and you can select the bottom rebar plan for this particular section. Again in the same process you can select all the rebar plan so that it will display the all the rebar plan, which is the combination of bottom as well as the top reinforcement section. So select section A, this is section B, profile section A, profile section B. So you can select the bill of materials here directly. So it will be consisting of bill of materials and rebar quantities option, and you can select the rebar strip views also. You can select here from this. So now I will directly select the rebar KGUF for the particular slab section so that it will load the rebar section view for the top reinforcement section as well as the bottom reinforcement section for the particular slab of 5th story. In the same process, you can select the rebar section rules and rebar quantities for the particular bottom story also. Bottom fourth story, third story, second story also. Now we can see this is the rebar cage view for the particular structural model. It will be consisting of reinforcement bar diagram like this, which is the combination of 10 mm diameter bar, 12 mm diameter bar. Select the beam detailing option, select the concrete beams, select the floor framing plan. This is the floor framing plan for the beam. So it will load here like this, and this is the schedule and drawing table for the particular beam section. It will be consisting of complete reinforcement design details for the particular beam. So this is the bill of material, rebar quantity. In the same process, you can check the elevation section with the different floor section. So this is the first elevation, 5C B1, beam number. So this is the A section, this is the B section, this is the C section, this is the D section, E, and this is the G section. So select the reinforcement profile, bill of material, rebar quantity, again rebar cage view, so that it will load the rebar cage view for the particular structural model here like this. It will be consisting of only 4 bars, which is consisting of bottom section as well as the top section for the particular building model. In the same process, you can select the column detailing option, select here, select the floor framing plan. This is the floor framing plan, this is the schedule and tabling for the particular structural model for the column, and select the elevation. It will be consisting of so many columns here, select any one of the column. This time selecting 8th number. So this is the column reinforcement design results for the particular section model. So directly I am selecting rebar cage view here, so that it will load the final rebar cage view for the building structural model by using ETAP software detailing version. So this is the reinforcement diagram, which is related to the slab reinforcement detailing for the particular structural model here like this. So this is the complete process of detailing of the building structural model by using ETAP software. So in this column section, it will be consisting of the combination of 16 mm diameter bar as well as the 12 mm diameter bar, which is exist here. So if you have any queries about this video, please try to text me your questions in the below comment box, so that I will give you the answer for that questions. Thank you.